Hi, you guys. Welcome to Audrey's reading area. Today's Tuesday. What kind of books do I read on Tuesdays, you guys? That's right. You got it. Educational books. Today's Educational Tuesdays. All right, you guys. Alexa, what time is Audrey's reading area?
Audrey reads in her area at 5 o'clock p.m.
All right. Let me get to this book. First, please click like, then hit share. Don't forget, hit like, hit share. Then go on over to Audrey's reading area on YouTube and smash that subscribe button for me. Smash it. Then go ahead and punch that notification bell so you can be notified every time I upload a new video. Now, what I want you to do is, listen as I read this fun and exciting and educational book. I love water. I love drinking water. I love swimming in water. Yes, science with water. Usborne Science Activities. Science with water. Take a gander. That means take a look. Science with water. This book, let me see who it was written by. And it doesn't say. I'm going to read the back. Science with Water. On the side, it says Helen Edom. Science with Water. Helen Edom. I guess it's written by Helen Edom. U.S. born book. On the back, it says Usborne Science Activities. Science with Water. It says this colorful book is packed with exciting scientific activities designed to help young children explore the intriguing properties of water. All the experiments and tricks are safe and easy to carry out using ordinary household equipment. Real examples show how people exploit water for transport, power, and so on. Usborne Science Activities, or Usborne Science Activities is an innovative series which responds to the growing emphasis on scientific exploration for young children. The text and illustrations are simple and clear, so children can enjoy using the books by themselves. Further notes give fuller scientific explanations for adults who wish to work with their children. Nice. So it's a series of books. So, consultant, it says Science with Water, consultant, Francis Nagy. Francis Nagy. And it has contents of the book. So, experimenting with water, you guys. Take a look. Experimenting with water. Now, just know that when you replay this video, you can freeze it so you can read it. Experimenting with water. Water behaves in some uprising ways. The experiments in this book will help you find out about them. Things you need. You can do all the experiments with everyday things. Here are some useful things to collect. Look for anything that holds water, sort of like a glass of my ice water. It says you can use bowls, you can use jars, you can use plastic containers. You need scissors, plastic tube, and tape. Being a scientist. Read what you have to do carefully. See if you can guess what might happen before you try an experiment. Watch closely to see if you were right. Write or draw everything you notice in a notebook. Write it down. Changing shape, that's up here. Looking at the top, lid on bottle, it says try gently shaking a bottle half full of water. What happens to the top or surface of the water? Let the bottle stand. What happens to the top now? Changing shape. Try doing these things to start finding out about water. Pour water on some hard ground outside. Pour more water into a small jar. Does the water make the same shape? Use a funnel so you don't spill any. Collect all types of glasses and bottles. Pour a full jar of water into each one. Can the water change to any shape? The water looks different in each thing. Ask a friend to guess which has the most water inside. Show that they all hold the same amount by emptying them back into the jar at one time. So here's some other experiments that you can read. Nice. Floating. We could do some floating in water. Some things float on water while others sink. Let's see. Which things float? Collect some things to test for floating. Can you guess which ones float before you put them in the water? Make a chart to show your results. So here's what the chart looks like. It says, look at the things that float. Are they all light? Are any of them big? Do they all float in the same way? Guess what happens if you attach a thing that floats to one that sinks? Underwater floating. Attach some modeling clay to a toothpick to make it float upright. Add more until it sinks. Take off a little at a time. Can you make a toothpick float just under the surface? It's right here. Then it has pushing power. Changing shape. We talked about that, testing shapes, how it works. You can read this. Freeze and read it. All right, you guys. Let's see. Fun with boats. I had fun with a boat 2 weeks ago. I was on a boat. I had so much fun. Boats float so well that they can carry heavy things across the water. Loading boats. Think of some things which might make good boats. You can see some here. Try them out on the water. Like this. Nice. Nice. Boat shaped from foil. Matchbox boat. It says, try loading a meat tray. Well, load your boats with a cargo of stones or marbles. Can some carry more than others? Try loading a meat tray with marbles. What happens? Load some marbles into an egg carton. What happens if you put them all at one end? Try putting one marble in each cup shape. Does it float better like this? Clay. Stick modeling clay under a jar so that it floats upright. Put a mark at the waterline. Load marbles gently into this boat. What happens to the mark? Interesting, huh? Submarine can. Push an empty drink can underwater so it fills with water and sinks. Poke one end of a plastic tube into the can. Blow into the other end. What happens? The air you blow into the can pushes out the water. This makes the can lighter so it rises to the surface. Then it talks about submarines down here. That was a submarine can. It says tanks inside a submarine can be filled with water to make it sink. Air is pumped into the tanks to make the submarine rise again. This is plimsoll line. Take a Take a gander. Look at that. Remember, you can pause this video so you can read it. Water's skin. Water's skin. Here are some surprises about the top or surface of water. Bulging glass. Fill a glass to the brim with water. Look closely at the top of the water. Gently slide in some coins, one at a time. Wow, look at that. And then here. It says, my water. It says, can you see the top rise above the glass? How many coins can you put in before the water overflows? Because it like comes up to the top and it seems like it's like a little bubble at the top, like this. The top of the water seems to bulge as if it is held by a thin skin. The surface of water often behaves like a skin. Floating a needle. You can float a needle by placing it carefully on the skin like this. See this picture of a needle and a spoon? It says, put a needle on a spoon. Slide the spoon into the water. See how the needle makes a dip in the skin? Try again gently if your needle sinks. Look at that one. You got to try gently. So it makes a dip in the skin of the water. That's interesting. Watch. What happens if you touch the water with a straw dipped in dishwashing liquid? The dishwashing liquid makes the skin weaker, so it stretches. It gets too stretchy to hold up the needle. Look, the needle drops. Drips and drops. Here's the page of drips and drops. Interesting. Drips and drops. Let's talk about the blowing bubbles right here. Stir a spoonful of water into 3 spoonfuls of dishwashing liquid. This mixture has a very stretchy skin. Bend some wire into a loop. Dip it into the mixture. Look at the skin across the loop. Blow gently. Watch how the skin stretches to make bubbles. That would be nice if I had my little bubbles. Do I have bubbles here? I had them someplace. I didn't know there was, I didn't read this in advance, so I would have had my bubbles ready to blow some bubbles. Oh, wow. Don't have any bubbles right now. I'm sorry. I'll have some bubbles next time. It says, I'm going to skip the drips and drops. I'm going to read the flattening drops. Spoon some drops into a clean plastic tray. Can you think of a way to make the drops flatter? Try touching them with a straw dipped in dishwashing liquid. The dishwashing liquid makes the skin stretch so the drops spread out. Nice. Vanishing water. Did you guys know that water vanishes? Vanishing water. You may have noticed how puddles dry up after rain. Have you ever wondered where the water goes? Finding out. You might think the water just soaks into the ground or runs away. Try an experiment to see if this is true. Pour some water into a saucer. Use a felt-tip pen to mark a line just above the water. Leave the saucer on a table for a few days. Look at your mark and the water level every day. The water slowly vanishes. It cannot run out or soak through the saucer. It must get out another way. And no, I didn't drink it. This is how water vanishes, you guys. The water escapes into the air in tiny drops called water vapors. They are too small to see. This is how puddles dries up. This shows water vapor evaporating from a saucer. Which dries fastest? Fill three more saucers. Leave one in a cool, shady place, one in a warm place, and one in a drafty place. Do they all dry out just as quickly, you think? Water in the air. The way water escapes into the air is called, and anybody guess? That's right, evaporation. Water evaporates all the time from rivers and seas, so the air is full of invisible water vapor. Getting water back. Fill a jar with ice cubes to make it cold. Does anything happen to the outside of the jar? Wipe it with a dry tissue. Does the tissue get damp? Water drops form on the jar because the cold jar cools the air nearby. When water vapor in the air cools, it drops. Its drops get big enough to see. This is called condensation. Condensation. Steam. Sometimes condensation happens in midair. Then the drops look like mist. This happens when water boils. The water gives off hot water vapor. This cools as it meets colder air and turns into drops you see as steam. It says never touch steam as it can burn you badly. Can burn you badly. Don't touch the steam. It says clouds and rain. Clouds are also made up of condensation drops. These form when water vapor rises from the ground and meets cold air above. Drops in the cloud join up and get heavier. Then they fall as rain. Yes. Now this says everlasting seas. Although water evaporates from seas, they never dry up. Enough rainwater runs into them to keep them full. Some interesting stuff about water, huh? It talks about mixing. And it talks about separating mixtures and solutions. Feel free to pause these pages if you would like. I'm going to read this excerpt right here. Instant food. Many foods are partly made of water. Soup, milk, and potatoes are often dried and stored as powder. When people want to eat them, they just mix them with water again. Mashed potatoes in a box, add water and butter. Water power. Water nearly always flows downhill. Its flow can push things strongly. Make a model water wheel. You will need two styrofoam egg cartons, two small paper plates, a stapler, some scissors. I have a stapler and scissors nearby. I don't have anything else. Two empty thread spools, a pencil, two long rulers or flat sticks, modeling clay, and clear tape. Cut cups out of the egg cartons. Okay. Staple them onto the plate as shown. Staple the second plate onto the other side of each cup. I guess it's going to look like this. And then when you staple the other plate, it's like you have the egg cups in the middle. See this? Interesting, right? Push the pencil through the center of the plates. Then push the thread spools into the end of the pencils. He says you may not need all of the cups. It says tape a ruler below each spool. Place the ruler across a bowl. Pour water on the wheels and watch what happens. That looks interesting, doesn't it? That would be a nice science project for somebody to do. Powering machinery. It says, can you get the wheel to turn faster? Probably pouring more water, right? It also says, what happens if you pour from higher up? How does the water turn the wheel? Powering machinery. Long ago, people used water wheels to turn machinery for grinding wheat into flour. Today, water is used to power machines that make electricity. The water spins huge wheels called turbines to make these machines work. Electricity is made like this in hydroelectric power stations. That's interesting, huh? Electric generator. Powerful pipes. Pipes to hydroelectric power stations take water from the bottom of the lakes or the reservoirs. The deeper the pipes are, the faster the water flows along them. And that's this one right here. Can you see? Getting stronger, it says. Take the top off an empty squeeze bottle. Make three holes in the bottle, one above the other. Tape over the holes. Fill the bottle with water. Then rip the tape off quickly. Watch how jets of water spurt out. Which goes farthest? The lowest jet should go farthest as water above it helps to push it out. That's interesting, huh? There you go, you guys. You're welcome. Science projects, huh? Science projects. We have some air and water tricks for you. Air and water tricks, it says. Most things that look empty are really full of air. Water has to push the air out before it can get in them. Tissue trick. Do you think you can keep a tissue dry underwater? Try this. First, stuff the tissue tightly into a glass so it cannot fall out. Turn the glass over and push it straight down into some water. Does the water fill the glass? Take the glass out. Is the tissue wet? Doesn't look like it. This works because the glass is full of air. The water cannot push the air out, so the tissue stays dry. What happens if you tilt the glass? Magic container. Then they have one that's called, let me show you magic container here. You can read. Flowing upward. Can you make water flow upward? That sounds interesting, right? It says, stand a glass in the kitchen sink. Put one end of a plastic tube in the glass. Put the other end under a faucet to fill the glass. Put your finger over the top of the tube. To keep the water in. Lift the glass up onto the counter with your other hand. Bend the tube until your finger is lower than the glass and take your finger off. The water should run up out of the glass through the tube. Can you think why? It says this is called a siphon. You're siphoning water. Nice. Siphoning water. How the siphon works. That's this right here. As water runs down the tube, it pulls up more water behind it. Air helps to push the water into the tube so the siphon keeps flowing. Air pushes here, where these green arrows are. Air pushes where the green arrows are. Water runs up the tube, and water runs out here, right here. See that picture? That's cool, huh? And there it is. Taking in water. Some things soak up water while others keep water out. Sounds interesting, doesn't it? Wetting different things. Let's see. Put a spoonful of water on a dry sponge. What happens to the water? Does all the sponge get wet? Does all the water disappear? Which things could you use for mopping up spills, which might be good for making umbrellas? So I will show you this, and you can read it and pause and read it. We have rising water. We have climbing through celery. There's some more experiments that we can do. Rising water. Do you think water can climb upward? Dip a paper towel into some water. Watch what happens. Right here. Then we talk about how plants drink. How plants drink. It says a plant has roots under the earth, under the dirt that it's planted in. These have tiny holes in them. Water in the earth goes into the roots. It is sucked up through the leaves, sucked up to the leaves through thin tubes in the stalk. See it right here? And it says, did you know in giant redwood trees, water has to climb over 300 feet to reach the highest leaf? Wow. Climbing through celery. I remember as a kid doing this experiment. I love it. I love it. You're going to put some color in the water, some food coloring. It says, pour a few drops of ink into a glass of water. Cut the end off a stalk of celery. Look at the cut edges closely. Then you put the stalk in the water. Leave it for 3 days. Does anything happen? What happens to the leaves? Do you see that? Starts to turn red. Then you inky spots. Cut the stalk into slices. Look for inky spots inside. These shows where water has risen up the stalk. Look at this. Isn't that interesting? Inky spots. Wow, that's interesting. Frozen water. Like my ice here. Ice is frozen water. When water gets very cold, it freezes hard and turns to ice. Differences. Look at an ice cube. How is it different from water? It says water can change shape because it is a liquid. Ice keeps one shape unless it melts and turns back to water. Anything that keeps its shape like ice is called a solid. Taking up space. See that? Taking up space. Find a plastic container with a lid. Fill it with water and put on the lid. Ask if you can put the container in the freezer. What happens when all the water turns to ice? Ice takes up more space than water. It pushes the lid up when it gets too big for the container. Does ice float? I think it does, but I put too many in there to tell. Put some ice in a bowl of water to see if it floats. How much floats above the surface, though? See right here? Icebergs. Look at this little tiny ship and this iceberg here. Wow. It says ships can sink if they hit the hidden part. Icebergs are huge chunks of ice that float in cold seas. Only the tip can be seen above the water. So this is the tip that's shown above the water, and the whole rest of the iceberg is under the water. Interesting. Melting ice. Ice melts when it gets warmer. Guess what happens if you put one ice cube in cold water, one in hot water, and one on a plate? That's what they're doing right here. Melting without heating. Try sprinkling an ice cube with salt. I tried that when I was little. Plus, I'm from New York. There's a lot of ice. We all know they sprinkle salt in the streets. Salt. What happens to the salt? The salt mixes with the ice. Salty ice melts quickly because it melts at cooler temperatures than plain ice. See it there? Try this out to see if you are right. Use a watch to time how fast they melt. Then here's another one. Try pressing an ice cube with a spoon handle. What happens to the ice here? Ice always melts when it is pressed. Did you guys know that? Ice always melts when it is pressed. I don't even think I knew that. Why ice is slippery? Ice melts when your foot presses on it. A thin layer of water forms under your shoes. This stops them from gripping, so you slide around. It makes it slippery, and that's why you slip. Because when you're pressing on it, see, I just learned something just like you guys. When you press on ice, it melts. So when you're walking, you're pressing on it, and so it melts and has that thin layer of water. So the water in between your foot and the ice makes you slide. I love learning. I hope you do too. Wow, that's so interesting. Read it, read it. Why ice is slippery. The end. Oh, that was the end of Science with Water. But it does have notes for parents and teachers, and guess what? I'm a parent and I'm a teacher. Although my child is grown. These notes give more detailed explanations for the scientific topics covered in this book. So it gives you more detailed explanation for the things on each page. I'll go up slowly so you can pause and read and pause and read. And then we'll do this page here so you can pause and read. I'm trying to flatten it so you can see it better. Pause and read and pause and read. Interesting, right? Some fun facts. Wow. Wow. Well, thank you, thank you, thank you guys for listening to me read fun and exciting books. I've got to shout out my one of my students named Joshua. He's a trip. Love these kids. I got to shout out Joshua. Joshua, shout out to you. Josh is always pulling up my videos in class. He's not supposed to, but he's always pulling up my videos and sitting here watching my videos and stuff in class. So shout out to you, Joshua. Science with Water, Helen Edom wrote this book. It doesn't talk about the illustrations, but these are some really good illustrations. Whoever drew these, kudos to you. It doesn't say. Maybe the same person that wrote it illustrated it. You never know. Shout out to my mom, who's always here, and my niece, Emlyn. Shout out to my cousin Ellie and my friend Victoria. They always share in my videos. And shout out to you guys. Shout out to you for being here and listening to me read fun and exciting and educational books like this, Science with Water. You know I enjoyed it. I learned right along with you. I didn't read this in advance. Otherwise, I would have had some more of these props and stuff like this, the scissors and the staple and the I would have done one of these experiments with you, but I guess next time when it says Science with Water, I'll try to read it first. But thank you, thank you, thank you so much. And I will see you again tomorrow, live at 5, right? LIVE, live at 5 tomorrow. All right, all right, all right. Let's do it together. LIVE, live at 5. See you tomorrow. See you soon. Don't forget, Audrey's Reading Area on YouTube. Go on over and smash that subscribe button for me.